محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه من يومنا هذا إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، قال تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. أما بعد، dear brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah today we're gonna start the khutbah with a question. Did you ask yourself why the follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be entering the Jannah first? We came at the end by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the first people who will enter the Jannah is the follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the answer for this question? Do we have something special? No, we didn't have anything special about us. The only measurement in the Day of Judgment is the good and bad deed, nothing else. Allah called himself Al-Adl. There is justice, there is fear, nothing, because we are special. Only thing at that day is bad deed and good deed. We have the Shafa'ah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that his da'wah that he kept asked for his ummah. But the measurement at that day is on the good deed and bad deed. Who has word deed will be entering the Jannah first. Let's lead us to the second question. How come we have word deed than they do, and they live more than we do? As you know, that's the average of the age of the follower of the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is between 60 and 80 years at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of us maybe reach 100 years of their age. Some of them were living more than 1,000 years. So they have longer life than we do. But we have more deed than they do. How that can happen? So it's simple. They have a longer life. But every good deed they had, they were written as one single reward. For every deed they had, only single reward. For the Prophet, for the Ummah of the Prophet, mashallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have a shorter life. But for every good deed that you do, Allah will write this as 10 times in the reward. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والحشرة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها. This is one part of the way that we'll be confront of those people in the day of the judgment, the way that we get more reward than them. Not only that, Allah give us many opportunities that will jump with our deed into the front of the other people. And some of this opportunity is the month of Ramadan. And some other opportunity is the charity. The charity was written for the follower of the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For each sadaqah that you give, it will be written as 700 times and more. For them, it was a single reward. For us, 700 times, and Allah will increase for ever whom will. So, this is the opportunity that Allah gave us to increase our hasanat, our reward. It's in every time of the year. We had Ramadan, we had the Friday every week. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Jum'atu ila Jum'ah, kuffaratu lima baynahuma, from the Friday to another Friday, and forgiveness for whatever happened between this. If there is no big sin, also from Ramadan to Ramadan is kuffaratun lima baynahuma. Allah will forgive you everything that you do between Ramadan to another Ramadan. Al-Hajj, also Al-Hajj, from Al-Hajj to Al-Hajj, kuffaratun lima baynahuma. So, also there is another opportunity that Allah give us, and give us a special days, and these days, we are living in one of those days, is the 10 of Dhul Hajjah. This 10 days is the best days in the life. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أفضل أيام الدنيا أيام العشر. The best days in the life is the 10, which is the first 10 that we are in the 10th day of the 10th of Dhul Hajjah. Why this is the best days in the life? For many reasons. The first reason that Al-Hajj is happening in those days. Not only that, there is that, as we know that Allah said in the Quran, Al-Hajj ashhurun ma'lumat, faman farada fihinna al-hajj fala rafatha wala fusuqa wala jidala fil hajj. وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى. Allah said, and this could be translated as, Hajj is well-known month, is a month. But if we look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hadith, he said, Al-Hajj Arafah. Arafah is one day of this 10 days. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Hajj Arafah. The Hajj is the day of Arafah. What that mean? It means anyone who went to do Al-Hajj and reach the day of Arafah, standing in the Jabal of Arafah, he reached the Hajj. If you miss this day, this means you didn't do the Hajj. So this is one of the important things that make these days the greatest days in the life. It's Yom Arafah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من صام يوم صيام يوم عرفة كفارة لسنتين سنة قادمة. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم will fast this day, which is يوم عرفة. Allah will forgive him for 2 years, the past year and the next, the following year. So just guess one day that you fast and you get reward for 2 years of this. The second reason that for making this the best days in the life, قال ابن حجر أن أمهات العبادات لا تجتمع إلا في هذه الأيام. Come together only in these days. Can we do a Hajj in another day? No. Because the Hajj has a system every year, and this Hajj having in this 10th of days. Can we do fasting? Yes, we can. The Prophet Muhammad
to fast the first night of the 10 days.